Hey, good morning, everybody. So today is Sunday. Just parked here over at the flea market here in town. It's about 30 minutes away from my house, but I haven't been in years. Like, I haven't been in a long time, but I've been seeing people on like Facebook Marketplace and Craigslist saying that they have a few shops that look like they had a couple things going on, games and stuff like that. So I'm gonna filter through here. It's a huge spot. It's huge. So I'm gonna take you guys with me today and figure out what's going on, see if there's any deals here. But the humidity is at 100% here in town, and I sweat profusely. So I'm not gonna elongate the process, but I'm gonna see if I can hit enough spots to see if we can find any deals. All right, let's go.
Thank you. Señora,
sí.
¿Cuánto es la caro?
¿Los carros? Allá 50 centavos, esto es 75, un dólar, dos dólares, y allá
50
centavos.
¿50 centavos? ¿Cuánto es?
¿Tres?
Ok.
106.5. Música. Buen gusto.
Francisco, ¿ligas con nosotros de Classic Chevy Sugar Line Highway 6? 0%, Francisco.
fisco de impuestos.
Digo, tenía más de esos
coches que el muchacho se lo llevó. Niñas, también tenemos muchísimos y tenemos las camionetas a cuatro.
How much for the game?
This one depends on the game, but the ones on the front for 360 and the Legend 3 are fine.
Okay. What about the Super Nintendos and Nintendo 64?
It depends on the game. Any game you look for?
Not in particular. Did you have you tested them?
Yeah, well, I have.
Oh, you got one. Okay, I got you. This used to be my favorite. Donkey Kong Country.
Yeah, so you can throw the monkey.
Yeah. I used to love this game, man. Which one?
Donkey Kong.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah. 1, 2, and 3.
Oh, you get them all the time?
One and two, yes, but the three one, the three is kind of hard to
do.
One and two, yeah.
Yeah.
I would bring you games every week.
Every week?
Well, people call me during the week. Like, I know for sure this week I'm getting food.
Oh, okay.
Mario Kart, that's like, people already asked for.
Yeah. Oh, Mario Kart?
Yeah, Mario Kart.
That's a popular one?
Mario Kart, yeah.
Okay. Let me, how much of the system, like, the 64? Are they refurbished?
Huh?
Are they refurbished?
Yes.
How much are they?
For this one, I'm 180. It's come with the Mario. It's come with Mario.
Okay.
For this one, 200. It's come with Donkey Kong and the original controller.
Okay.
This one, it come with this controller. For
okay.
This one, I won 140. It comes with the Mario. Mario 64 and one controller.
Okay.
Or I can do 160 and Golden Eye with the controller.
There's not enough meat on the bone for me.
Oh, you sell?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Where you sell?
Everywhere. Mostly online.
Online?
Yeah. Okay.
For collectors?
Hmm?
Collectors or just random?
Just anybody.
Just anybody?
Yeah. Make sure they don't fall out.
It's okay.
Okay. On the wrestling, are all of them $10? Are they all different prices? Or you got any on special?
No, I have only the $8, $10, $12.
All right, guys. So my GoPro died, and it wasn't enough excitement for me to. Wasn't enough excitement for me to stop and put another battery in. All of the prices was overpriced. I grabbed a Hulk action figure for my son and a little car. But out of all the places that had, it was a lot of toys, a lot of good toys actually that they had in there, but not enough meat on the bone for me. It wasn't enough willing and dealing that I could have did to get a price where I would want and be comfortable at enough to make a profit. So good stuff, but they're all overpriced. Everybody's asking a premium for all their toys. So that's that. And I don't know what else I'm gonna do today, but I may go to a Goodwill or something on the way home. Quite disappointing for a 30-something minute drive. Hey, what's up, everybody? Just wanted to show you what I got from Goodwill today. I got quite a bit, so let's take a look. All right, so first I have a set of four Bucler copper brass holders with the glass in there, which is usually meant for like Irish coffee. You can use it for tea as well. These are from like the 70s, 1970s. I've had this set before, and they do okay. I mean, it's not highly sought after, but I like the design of them. So I picked these up for $9. It's a set of four, and it's just copper and brass all around. Has wear on, all of them have wear, some more than others. And this glass actually comes out like that, and they just set in there. So you have hot, any kind of hot beverage in there, and you can set them in there like so, and you sip your tea or sip your coffee like that. Next, I have this really cool stoneware mug with a bear as a tree. It's hand painted, and it's from the year 1999 because it's marked at the bottom there. And that's what I paid for, $1.99 for it. And I really actually like this mug for myself. It's hand painted, but it's not hand spun. As you can tell, if you look inside and you see the circles, you can tell that that's machine done. That's not hand done. If you see like drips or anything bulging out, pretty much any kind of imperfection, that's more prone to being hand done than machine. But you can see the circles from the turner. So, but it's a really cool mug. I like it. I'll probably list it for, I don't know, $13.99, $14.99, something like that, plus shipping. Really cool mug, very well designed. See how it bowls out, comes out here, goes back in. I like it. All right, next I have this set of salt and pepper shakers. They're a nice size. They're probably about 3 inches and some change in height. It's kind of a Native American theme. Transferware, it's not hand painted, but I paid $2.99 for them, and it looks like, I can't read who it's made by. It's really not that important. They're gonna sell for what they're gonna sell for anyway, because these are kind of all general in the same boat, and look, got pepper leaking out. Anyway, I picked those up for that, and I'll probably list these for like $14.99, $15.99 as well. Next, I have this Shed Hydrographic Carbon Fiber Helmet. I think it's a softball helmet. But anyway, I picked that up for $7.99. That's a really cool helmet. Needs some cleaning up, but it's no major damage on it. Just needs a good wipe. It's a size small. Let's see. Yeah, it's a size small. So yeah, picked that up for $7.99. I've seen these going for anywhere between $30 and $40. Next, I picked up these Roundhouse Overalls Vintage Jeans. These are actually pretty cool and they sell well. I don't come across them that often, but when I do, they sell rather quickly. That's the logo. Be on the lookout for these. These overalls will sell for around $40 pre-owned. And I paid $6.99 for them. So this should be a good little deal here. It's like a, see this buckle here? I have to redo this buckle, put another buckle on, and it'll be good to go. All right, next I picked up this Spray Grounds backpack. Here's a bolo for you guys. If you have never picked up a spray ground or came across them, please be on the lookout for these. These sell very well. They're real good in the skateboard community, just in the urban community in general. But they're really collectible. They have many different styles, makes and models. None of them look the same. Well,
I can't say that. Some of them look the same, but in different colors and different, like it may have camouflage on here or a different material, leather versus the vinyl or cloth or velvet. It's all kind of makes and models of them. And they go up as high as $500. So I picked this up for $6.99 here from Goodwill as well. And it came with like a little pin that the previous owner had on there. My mustache is always one step ahead. So I may leave that on there. I may take it off, I don't know. But this one, I don't know the character's name, but I believe it's from South Park. And he's smoking a joint. So I think this will be a good depop list here. That's the logo. And make sure if it does say spray grounds, when you open it up, it should have a tag in there that says spray ground as well. And sometimes they'll have the model like in between here, where they list the cities in the spray ground. It'll have a model number, or it'll be down at the bottom of here. So, but yeah, this one's pretty clean. Hardly ever used. Great material. And that's the back of it. That spray ground right there, and actually has South Park right here on the shoulder strap. So, really good condition. I have not found a comp for this one yet. I haven't, there's none out there available or sold for this particular one. So I may run it as an auction, and I'm gonna probably start it off around $75 and see what the market tells me it's worth. And I'm fine with that. So yeah, if you're ever out and about, pay attention to spray grounds. I've seen them sell for $30. And I've seen some sell for $300-$400 pre-owned, new. They go all the way up to $500. All right, next I picked up this My Little Pony Build-A-Bear plush with skates. And it's actually functional skates on them. So yeah, that was actually pretty cool. Nice size on her. She has a little, what do you call it? It's not a... Yeah, is it a tutu? Is that supposed to be a tutu, or is she supposed to be a mermaid? I don't know. But anyway, she has a helmet on that comes out. It's only Velcroed on, so you can take that off. So yeah, it's pretty cool from the Build-A-Bear Workshop. So I don't know what this is gonna bring. I know it's some My Little Pony collectors out there, but being that it's a Build-A-Bear, I'm not sure if it's a market for it or not. I'm sure somebody will want it, but I'm not sure on what the price is quite yet. Got to do some more research. Next, I picked up this Ryan's World treasure chest little set here. And it comes with the little captain hat that you can put on. And the little eye patch here. The red little shawl, and it came with these figures here. I don't know really anything about Ryan's World, I'm not gonna lie. So I came with those and these two. Okay, she's not gonna stand up. That came with these. These are like a little rubber squishy, all three of these. And it came with like a backpack clip of Ryan. And some coins. Some keys. Is this a compass? I don't know what that is. And down here we have the boat there. And it has a lock and it has like a little chest in there. And some mystery goo that's already been used. I've opened that to check. And the putty is new. They haven't used that. But this is really no good because this is all kind of junk in here. This little compartment, nothing
So yeah, I got that for $9.99. The sticker's upside down, but I paid $9.99 for this. These figures by itself, like this one, I've seen some sold comps for like $9.99. And the other one's about $8-$9 each. But I tried to look this one up, this gold one, and it's no comp available for this. It's not, I haven't even seen one for sale, let alone being sold. So I'm thinking maybe this one is a rare one. It does have some few scuffs on it, but I think this is a rare little figure here. They're made by Bunkers Toys. So I don't know what I'm gonna do with that, but the rest of them, you can say that these are worth about $8 to $9 a piece. The ship, I seen a sold comp on that for $19.99 for just the ship alone. I have not seen one with the actual treasure chest. So I don't know if I wanna sell it all together or piece it out. I'm gonna weigh my options on that. All right, last I picked up this Ping Golf backpack. I paid $5.99 for it, and the sold comps are kind of all over the place for the backpacks, but they're good sold comps, anywhere between $30 and $50 is what I'm looking at for a pre-owned Ping Golf backpack. It's pretty cool. A lot of pockets, it's all black. Needs some cleaning for sure, but it's in really good condition for what it's worth. So all the buckles work, not buckles, the zippers work. No tears, a few stains that needs to be cleaned, but other than that, probably gonna list it for around $39.99 plus shipping. All right, so that's all I got for you guys today. Make sure you hit the subscribe button, share, like, and I would like to try to get to doing more videos maybe once every other day. So be on the lookout for more content and bolos. All right, see you guys later. Peace.